Been a pretty good weekend so far, if you ask me. So, got a commitment from five-star athlete Makai Lemon, and just setting the foundation for this 2023 class for Oklahoma. Oh, by the way, who's his quarterback? Oh, Malachi Nelson, the number one quarterback in the country for 2023, depending on who you ask. But he's the number one quarterback as far as I'm concerned. And, you know, just got a big-time in-state commit at tight end with Luke Haz. And then, you know, Treyon Webb. Yeah, the 2023 class looking kind of good, guys. The foundation is there. Get excited. But talking about Makai Lemon, just you look at his highlights. What's fun to watch his highlights, Malachi Nelson's his quarterback. So you get to see the best of both worlds when those guys play. So you get to see him make plays with his QB that he's likely going to be playing with when he comes to Oklahoma. And he is great. He is amazing. Yak yards, if you're a fan of yak yards, screen plays, you know, just great in open space. He's also not too bad. He's a pretty decent corner, too. I mean, he's really good there, too. That's why they got him listed as an athlete on 24/7. But this is what to take away from this, because I know – I have people in the comments all the time, oh, big deal, we get like quarterbacks and wide receivers all the time. Where's the defensive guys? Guys, be patient. For all you out there who are like that, be patient. Those are coming. 2023 is setting up to be very special. Because I'm telling you, I'm calling it now, we're getting LT Overton, the number one player in the country on the D-line. I'm just, be patient on this one. Some of these guys take their entire recruiting cycle, their entire recruiting period to make a decision, because either they want to have the really big stage at some of these All-Star games, the, you know, it's not the Army All-American game, but whether it's the All-American game or the Under Armour game, or sometimes they just want to wait until National Signing Day. But nowadays the new National Signing Day is December. December is the new National Signing Day. Some guys might wait till February, you never know. But those big-time recruits are coming. We've been getting some of these recruits, like, in the past couple years anyway. They've been very sneaky. You know, like, we've gotten some this year, the previous year. So guys that are probably going to play this year on the D-line. So just be patient. Those guys are coming, because we're going to get some big-time players, I promise you, because 2023, I can't wait to see what 2023 has. And the wide receiver, like Brandon Innes is another guy that's right there in the top 10 we can get. And along with DeAndre Moore. So I know some people wanted Hale as well. He's another big-time player, but I don't know how many receivers we're going to take. You know, more the merrier, I guess. But there's some people out there who are super concerned about Talon Shetron. You know, with the whole SEC news, is he going to still go to Oklahoma State with his brother and everything? It's like, guys, that ship has sailed. Don't worry about that. The receiving talent for 23 is going to be sick. Get excited for that. So there is still, for those who follow the Lincoln Riley eyeball emojis, there's still one outstanding. I believe the word around the campfire is that it's on defense. So if you like defense, you know, stay tuned for that. But yeah, big get for Oklahoma. And it's just, it's not a coincidence that, you know, we're getting Makai Lemon, and, you know, who knows how long it's going to take for DeAndre Moore to make his commitment. But got a good shot at getting him. Let's put it that way. I'm stoked, guys, because this class, 2023, this could be potentially the first class going into the SEC. There's an outside chance we might not do 22, just how logistics and everything, but regardless, this is more than likely will be a class that will play its entire run as members of the Southeastern Conference. And if you're building a special class for that move, it's setting the table for a run. I'm not going to tell you we're going to win like 4 or 5 conference titles in a row. That's not what I'm saying. But we're not walking into the SEC just, well, hopefully we can compete. Like, we're not Texas. We're walking in there to compete day one. We're walking there to compete to get to Atlanta, walking in there to compete to get to the playoff and win national titles. That's where this program is just going trajectory, man. I'm just stoked about this. I cannot wait to see where this goes, but a lot of potential. So get excited. All right, I'm done rambling, because that's pretty much what this video has been. Hope you all have a good weekend. Like, subscribe, all the good stuff. For those who are new, the season's coming up really quick. I do watch along videos, previews, funny comedy stuff. You know, if you like OU football, you like college football in general, I'm your guy. So with that being said, Boomer Sooner, I am out, and Like I said, enjoy your weekend. We just got a 5-star. Isn't it awesome? Our 5-star is awesome. Later.